Hi, I decided to make a little bit different video this time, a little bit more personal regarding on the situation in the world right now. Today, as I'm filming this, was the first death for Corona-19 in headlines in Finland. It has now gone 8 days that my family and I have been living in isolation in our house, me and my wife working remotely. The kids are away from school as they are closed, and we are teaching our children here at home. Things have gone really well, I must say. I see that we are the fortunate ones over here. Many of my musician friends are in terrible situation. Every single one of their gigs have been cancelled for unknown period. Myself, I actually had to cancel only one studio session. I am part of the risk group, and the session was on that nature that we can't really just send the files from my home. So that got cancelled, and that's okay. In the times like this, it's really interesting how much I have been thinking about why and how I started to play. We had a band when I was 10 years old, and we did gigs all the time. All my best friends were playing in that band, and we're still doing gigs together sometimes. I am wondering how much does this situation affect on my fellow musicians, not only financially, but also socially and mentally. The gigs are very much social events, also for musicians, we all know that. Also, one of the aspects of playing in the band as a teenager and as a kid was also the dreams and hopes that maybe someday I would be working as a professional musician. Now, this was a very big part of studying and playing. Now, I don't think that any of us kids, you know, really wanted to be a rock stars. We just wanted to make a living as a professional musicians. In music, generally, there's a lot of aspects and elements of hopes and dreams. Hope to be successful and hope to be loved and hope to survive. One friend of mine, a very famous singer-songwriter from Finland called Jukka, once told me as we were making his solo record in the studio that even though he has written thousands of songs, literally, there is not even one that doesn't include the aspect of hope somehow. He saw it actually as a mission to be a songwriter and a musician, to bring hope to others. Now, do you remember the old Procol Harum song called Pandoras Box? Do you know the original story of Pandoras Box? According to Hesiod, when Prometheus stole the fire from heaven, Zeus, the king of gods, took vengeance by presenting Pandora to his brother Epimetheus. Now, Pandora opens the jar left in his care, containing sickness and death and many other unspecified evils that were then released in the world. Though she hastened to close the container, only one thing was left behind, and that thing is usually translated as hope. I must say that I'm really worried for my fellow musicians. Some of us, as I do, have school-aged children at home. Some of us are worrying about the risk of getting affected. Some are paralyzed of concern for their loved ones. And some of us suffer from diminishing social life and money. My wife and I took out the family for a trip to the forests nearby yesterday. It feels unbelievable to see how much love I have around me. I know that we are the fortunate ones, not only because we have an excellent chance to stay healthy and alive, but also that I can spend my time in solitude with these wonderful people. I know that the worst times are ahead. But I still want to see that there is always an idea in the future for something better. The story of Pandora's Box is a good reminder that wherever there is life, there is hope. There is always a promise in tomorrow that things are getting better. The more I think about it, I do come to the conclusion that this was the real meaning, a mission for me as a musician, to bring hope and dreams to others. Please, take care of yourself and the people around you. There are many more good things coming ahead. In that, you know, and I know, that music is the best.